Hi guys, my name is Anuj Jindal. Welcome to my channel. Today we are going to pick up another English topic and understand how to write the introduction, the body and the conclusion, and also understand how to and what kind of points to be mentioned in the body paragraph so that you get maximum points, maximum marks in the examination. RBI and SEBI examinations are right to the point, and therefore we need to make sure that we are very well prepared for English, which forms a very important portion of our preparation. In case you like this lesson, do not forget to subscribe to the channel for more such videos, and also press that little bell icon so that you get a notification at the end of every video that I publish, so that you know that I've published something and you can grab it and watch it for your own benefit. Okay, so the topic that we have today is called as how can global trade contribute to India's prosperity. Now, as we've done in the past lessons also, we are going to identify the keywords in the topic that we have. Number one, how can global trade, so we are going to talk about global trade, contribute to India's prosperity. That means we have to link global trade with India's economic, political, social, all kinds of prosperity that India can achieve through global trade. Okay, looks and sounds a little difficult, but it's a very easy topic, and you will understand that once we start discussing the points in the body paragraph. In the introduction, you can talk about the definition or the meaning of global trade and its linkage with India's prosperity and the importance of global trade for any country's economic and other kinds of prosperities. The importance and the definition, these two things you have to talk about. Okay, now coming to the body part, what are the points from multi dimensions, as I have said in my past videos also, do you need to mention? The first one is a hike in global trade means more opportunities for Indian exports and exporters. More global trade means more opportunities for Indian exports. Let's say a very crude example, let's say global trade in services expand in such a way that, let's say, RBI also starts hiring from international arena, or to put in another way, let's say our education system is reformed in such a way that we are also teaching whatever is being taught in the global arena. In that scenario, we are competing with the global population for jobs, for opportunities, and let's say in that competition, RBI is one of them. RBI starts hiring from the global arena. That means more opportunities for me because I can export my services in that case. Okay, so this is how a hike in global trade, whether in services, whether in goods, whether in activities, in anything, means more opportunities for Indian exports, exports in services as well as exports in goods. Okay, number two, better quality and cheaper production in Indian market due to competition. Now, competition has been proven to be beneficial for the people, for the local people. It was considered immediately after World War II that competition is not good, let's close down our economies. But now it has been proven beyond any doubt that competition is good. Therefore, if there is a hike in global trade, that means more competition. That means better quality production in India. That means cheaper production in Indian market, because with competition comes a price war as well as the a hike in quality. It can also be connected with the first point that I mentioned, that more opportunities for me, because now the entire world is going to take RBI examination. With this opportunity, a threat will also come for me that more people are going to be teaching for RBI. Therefore, what will happen as a result? Better quality of preparation. Certainly, more people will come with better ideas I will have to adopt, and cheaper products. The price might go down in the short term because now there are more people coming in the arena and teaching and trying to explore this area. More teachers are going to be entering this arena. So more competition means better quality and cheaper products. Better global trade can push India to reform its regulatory environment, encouraging new investments in India. Now, if there is higher global trade, the regulatory environment is pushed in India or in any country, because if you want to be a part of that push of global trade, if you want to be a part of that movement of global trade, you have to change your regulatory environment so that investors from across the world are willing to invest in your country. For example, recently the corporate tax rate has been reduced to 22%. Now, it was mentioned in the newspapers that it's going to be bringing in a lot of new investments in the economy. Why? Because now foreign investors feel that it is same in investing in India is similar to investing in China. Why? Because the corporate tax rates are a lot similar now. They used to be much higher in India, and therefore they did not want to expand or invest in India, but now they do. So this is going to bring in new investments. Similarly, regulatory environments also change and brings in more prosperity for the local people as well. Fourth one is, a prosperous global trade will help India improve its logistics and border management. More global trade, specifically in goods, means that you have to adapt or improve your logistics sector. You have to improve your border management so that all that global trade is attracted to your local destination and it does not go elsewhere. Okay, let's say some set of goods are coming in from the US to India, and they find that in India, after they launch, the time after they land, sorry, the time it takes for the goods to reach the masses is more than a month. They will not be investing in that case, because the inventory is getting stuck in that logistics part, and their money is getting stuck in borders of India. On the other hand, if in China it takes one day to get clearance on the border and to reach, you know, the inner areas, the cities of the country, they would be more interested in selling there. So this is how a prosperous global trade can push India to develop its logistics and laws in such a manner that they are more beneficial, and that in sync will also benefit India, because more infrastructure, better laws, more advantages to the exporter simultaneously. One step closer towards internationalization of rupee. More global trade means more participation of India. If India is able to participate more in the global trade, that means rupee can be used or might be used as a method of paying or exchanging money in different countries, which can result into internationalization of rupee, just like the US dollar is an internationalized currency. A steady global trade with the will reduce volatility in rupee, because if the global trade is steady, any effect or any volatility in one part of the world will be offset by growth in another part of the world, therefore less volatility in rupee. Seventh point is, capital account convertibility can be made possible if global trade increases, and with it Indian trade also increases. India still has current account convertibility. We do not have capital account convertibility. If global trade increases, Indian trade also increases, then India might open its currency to capital account convertibility, which will ensure that investors can come in and invest in India for long term without worrying about converting their currency into the local currency. And the last is, internationalizing our banking industry and capital markets. Now, if global trade is happening in India, it is not only happening in goods or services, it is also happening in the stock market simultaneously, in the banking industry simultaneously. Therefore, we can internationalize, globalize our banking industry and capital markets only with a more steady and more growing global trade. See, the diversity of points that I have picked up in this particular topic is immense. We talked about the banking industry, capital markets, we talked about rupee volatility, we talked about internationalization of rupee, we talked about capital account convertibility, we talked about logistics and border, which is a different area altogether. We talked about bringing in new investments and laws, which means better regulations. We've talked about competition, and we've also talked about more opportunities for the people. So we've talked about different perspectives, different dimensions, and that is what makes your essay more wholesome. It's like a big thali on the plate for the examiner, which he can actually enjoy. If there is a thali which has, let's say, four sabjis and everything, and if there is a thali where there is only one vegetable and one roti and one rice, set of rice, of course the first one is more interesting, at the same time more satisfying to the person who's eating it. Similarly, if you are covering it from different dimensions, it's going to be more satisfying. Okay, so this was about this particular session where we talked about one more topic from essay. In the future videos, I'll pick up more and more topics in order to make sure that you understand the intricacies of writing an essay in a better manner and presenting it in a way that is more satisfying to the examiner.